So we continue here. It is quite simple. Just what we can say, junior college of algebra. Even that way, it is late high school, but we can say junior college of algebra. So whenever J is there, you go till you get something in terms of something plus J something.
So everything in J is to be simplified by using J square equal to minus 1 by your conventional complex number logic, and you go for 1 plus J, A plus JB. So you simplify everything in terms of A plus JB.
So we get it here. Omega gets cancelled here. So the numerator is minus J square, that is omega gets cancelled minus J square, that is minus J square minus 1. So numerator is 1. And denominator I write as it is 1 upon j omega minus j upon omega. Multiply numerator and denominator by omega, we get omega upon j omega square minus j. So that is omega upon j into bracket omega square minus 1. Omega upon j into bracket omega square minus 1.
Multiply again, j is not to be kept in the denominator. So always go with such simplification till you get a plus jb.
So multiplying numerator denominator by j again. Multiplying numerator denominator by j again. So effective impedance z is equal to j omega upon 1 minus omega square. That is j into bracket omega upon 1 minus omega square is the parallel impedance of LC, is the impedance of LC parallel circuit with L equal to 1 and C equal to 1. So this is so when I apply input as sin omega t, this z, that is the parallel combination, is j into bracket omega upon 1 minus omega square. So what this is? What is this z? We did not have any resistor in the circuit. We do not have any resistor in the circuit. So this is z, which is equal to j upon omega upon 1 minus omega square. So in the form of a plus jb, it is a0 plus j into this omega upon 1 minus omega square. So one thing is very clear, that the resistive part is 0. So impedance of L parallel C is purely reactive, j into bracket, which is something function of omega. If omega is less than 1, what will happen? If omega is less than 1, in that case, the denominator will be positive. So numerator, we go for only positive omega. Negative omega is a simple thing, but right now, see, this electronics engineering and especially circuit theory, when we look with some such complex impedances, things are somewhat difficult or somewhat complicated. So we initially deal with the simpler version. If we say that everything in the world is complicated, then it is just impossible for a human being to understand the entire world. But we don't go for understanding of entire world, we go step by step. So if omega is, we say that the concept of frequency of a sinusoid is positive. In that case, if omega is less than 1, numerator is positive, denominator is positive, so overall ratio is positive. So it is j into something positive number. J into positive is inductive, is like an inductor. J into something positive is reactance of an inductor. J omega L. J into something negative is like reactance of capacitor, because it is minus J upon omega C. So for omega less than 1, this ratio or this entire number or this b jb, this is positive. The parallel combination of inductor and capacitor behaves like an inductor in case of omega less than 1. For omega more than 1, what will happen? Numerator positive, denominator negative, it works as capacitor. And for omega equal to 1, what will happen? For omega equal to 1, what will happen is that denominator will become 0. Denominator will become 0 and impedance will become infinite. Impedance will become infinite. So it will be open circuit. For omega equal to 1, the impedance is 0 plus j infinity. 0 plus, because omega square is 1. So it is open circuit. No current will flow. There will be current in inductor, there will be current in capacitor, but at resonant frequency for LC parallel circuit, the direction of current in capacitor and inductor is equal and opposite. So net current is zero. So you apply some voltage, no current is drawn. So that means that you apply some voltage, no current is drawn. It means that it is an open circuit. It is an open circuit. Now, what about LC series circuit? Same last time we consider. Again 1 and 1. So their net impedance Z is XC or XL plus XC, so L is 1, so it is J omega plus minus J upon omega C, so it is J into bracket omega minus 1 upon omega, omega minus 1 upon omega. For parallel it was, Z was J into bracket omega upon 1 minus omega square. So it is for parallel and it is for series. So for a parallel circuit, what happens? At omega less than 1, this positive, overall positive, it is like inductor. For omega more than 1, this positive, this negative, it is like capacitor. For omega equal to 1, this positive or this 1, this denominator is 0, it is open circuit. For LC series circuit now, for omega equal to 1, what will happen? 1 minus 1, that is 0, so impedance is 0, it is short circuit. LC series circuit behaves like a short circuit for omega equal to 1. If L is equal to 1 and C is equal to 1. Then for omega less than 1. So if omega is, we can say omega more than 1. If omega is 2, it is half. So omega more than 1, it is positive. So it behaves like an inductor. For omega less than 1, if omega half, minus 1 upon half, it happens 2. That is, half minus 2 is negative, so it is capacitor. So LC series circuit. So I can write omega less than 1, omega equal to 1, omega more than 1. LC series circuit. LC parallel circuit. For LC series circuit, omega less than 1, it impedance is capacitive. For omega equal to 1, impedance is infinite, open circuit. It is inductive. impedance is negative, impedance is infinite, impedance is positive. For series circuit, for parallel circuit, it is exactly reverse. Impedance is inductive. Because 1 upon omega column as omega square or positive. For here, I am sorry, it is 0 short. For parallel to infinity open. And it is capacitive. So, LC circuit behaves in an interesting manner, series circuit behaves in a different manner, parallel circuit behaves in a different manner, and in that if you add resistance, what will happen? Overall will not become short. If you add resistance in parallel, overall will not become open. So, in general, you can have, this is for L equal to 1 and C equal to 1 we have taken. But now these two need not be 1 and 1. So we can have it as L and C in general terms. If we take general terms, what is this impedance? It is J omega L minus J upon omega C. This is equal to J into bracket omega L minus 1 upon omega C. Omega L minus 1 upon omega C. And now for simplification purpose, at what frequencies these two will be equal? When omega L equals 1 upon omega C, these two will be equal. It is resonance. The impedance is 0 for LC series circuit. So omega L equals 1 upon omega L equals 1 upon omega C. Omega come on this side. So omega square equal to 1 upon root LC. At that frequency, this is called as also, omega square equal to 1 upon LC. So, omega equal to 1 upon root LC, this frequency is called as omega R. This frequency is called as omega R. And you can have omega less than resonance, omega greater than resonance. For series circuit, for parallel circuit. And now, there is a very interesting term which you carry it with you. This is not possible, but in practice, but in theory it is possible. We will be discussing about the power dissipation and all that. It is also very simple. Most of you must have this studied this in standard 11-12, even in the first year basic electrical engineering. The purpose for which we will be discussing it today is to have a more clear idea. Now we had done this circuit. So and we had applied say sin omega t. Or this is 1 and this is 1. Now let us say I apply sin t, means I deliberately choose omega equal to 1. So what will happen? This curve will be cos t, this current is minus cos t, and this net current is 0. So if net current is, so this is a very interesting question. I would like to appeal to everybody to think it. Suppose if I connect this, so the moment at which I connect this, when I say I connect this, it is not sin t because it is, I am connecting at some point. But right now you ignore that, you can assume that I connect it and allow it. Suppose that, will you get any theme that you have learned something infinite time ago? You will not get that, but what I tell today is fresh for you. What was taught in first standard for you,
it is as good as now you carry a perception that you have been knowing it for years together. So if I apply sin t, there will be current in inductor, there will be current in capacitor. Current in capacitor is cos t, current in inductor is minus cos t, and net current is zero. Net current is zero. And if it is like this, if net current is zero, if I disconnect this, what will happen? I am connected, I am disconnected. What will happen?
It's a very interesting thing.
This was the circuit. That time nothing was there, nothing was there. 1 Henry, 1 Farad. This was not concept of any kind of current as such. Right now, and if I connect this, if I connect sin t, if I connect sin t to this, there will be current in this, there will be current in this, current in this would be cos t, current in this would be minus cos t, and total current will not flow. So connection of this will produce, so earlier this was the situation. So what this is, what this is. So this is called as LC tank circuit. In oscillator you might have learnt sometime, those who may have vocational 12th and not understood, because it is very LC tank circuit is one of the complex phenomena in the world. So what peculiarity it is having? So if peculiarity what it is having is, if you go for its differential equation, if you go for its differential equation, right now I take 1 and 1. If you go for its differential equation, then you will find that the differential equation has got a very interesting solution. So when you connect this and disconnect this, so when you disconnect this, what will happen to the currents here? So what will happen is that it's I am time level best. When we learnt it decades back, how oscillations are produced in LC circuit is something which many generations of electronics engineers all over the world are confused and will remain confused, and their journey as an engineer will end in that confusion. Then you will say, what great deal you are trying by clarifying it. I would like to very candidly say that confusion is something, and every confusion in the world need not be clear. Every confusion in the world need not become clear. There would be few confusions which will remain with an individual till the end of his life, and nothing will be, what we can say, impacting on his life because of that confusion. But let us try to clear whatsoever confusions we can. So very interesting thing I am telling you, that right now the capacitor discharge, if you bring, I am telling a very interesting experiment, bring one capacitor from market, bring one inductor from market, connect them to each other. Bring one capacitor, bring one inductor, connect them to each other, right? So this is what you have done. So is there any current? No. So what is current through this? Zero. What is current through this? Zero. So no current, no voltage. No current, no voltage. Then connect it here, bring one source, voltage source, have it here, and close the switch. And close the switch. I am trying my level best. To what extent I will succeed, I don't know. Now close the switch. When you close the switch, what is voltage across it? Sin t. Current through this is cos t. Current through this is minus cos t. Net current is zero. Net voltage is sin t. And now I am asking question. Those who want to answer on their own should put a pause button on the video, think, and then resume. The question is, I connect sin t for some time, say 5 minutes, and I disconnect it, what will happen across the LC circuit? You can put the pause if you want to think. Think and then put start. Those who don't want to think and continue to listen, hoping that they are listening. So what will happen is that, listen very carefully. I am trying my level best. I am trying explaining simple words. LC circuit was there. There was nothing. No current, no voltage. I brought a voltage source. I connected a voltage source. And I disconnected a voltage source. And so, if I have a voltmeter here, AC voltmeter, and if I have ammeters here, AC ammeters, current, major current, I have a voltage source here. If I, this is voltmeter. So AC voltmeter, AC emitter, one farad capacitor, one Henry inductor connected like this, no voltage, no current. When I close this switch, what will happen? Voltmeter will show 1 volt, AC, assuming that the voltmeter is approved, it's AC voltmeter with accurate depiction on that, or you can see on CRO also. So when it was not connected, no voltage, no current. When we connect, voltmeter will show voltage, ammeter will show currents. These two currents would be exactly equal because ammeter shows net current. That for, if you want direction, you can plot the waveform of the direction somehow separately. You close it, you see before closure, no voltage, no currents. After closure, when you connect source, voltage and current. And the most magic is what will happen if I disconnect. You can put a pause, think and resume. Put a pause now if you want to. If you disconnect, you will find that voltmeter will continue to show the amplitude is 1. It is A sin omega t. A is 1. A is 1. 1, it is 1. 1 sin 1 t means sin t. So it is a 1 volt peak, 1 omega 1 means frequency 1 upon 2 pi hertz. So a sinusoid waveform of amplitude 1 volt and frequency 1 upon 2 pi hertz is called as sin t. If I connect it, here I will get some RMS reading, that 0.707, and this is also 0.707, this is also 0.707. So when I connect, the voltmeters and ammeters will show the values. Even if I disconnect, they will continue to show the values. What? So if I make LC circuit to oscillate at its resonant frequency, once it will continue to oscillate, it is just like pendulum. Pendulum, you have put the pendulum. When you put the pendulum as it is, so what will happen? If pendulum is as it is, it will not start swinging. A stationary pendulum remains stationary. A stationary pendulum remains stationary, it will not swing as it is. But if you bring it from here to here and then release it, it will continue to oscillate. It will continue to oscillate. If you bring it here and then release it, it will continue to oscillate here. And if everything is vacuum and no friction, nothing else, the pendulum will continue to oscillate in the range in which oscillations were started and never died down. Oscillations will be sustained oscillations and they will never die down. In ideal situation. In practical situation, it doesn't happen, so you need battery cell. So here, the LC circuit can have sustained oscillations, because whatever voltage here, current here, current here, cos t minus cos t, if currents flow, voltage here will be obviously V, which is sin t. So once the oscillations are created, there is no need for power supply or AC power supply to continue oscillations, because LC tank circuit, inductor and capacitor connected in parallel with each other, create an environment appropriately with equal opposite things. I take it on this side, when it comes from this to this, it here potential energy is maximum, kinetic energy is zero. Potential maximum, kinetic is zero. It gets converted and it continues in this manner. So, taking on this side, max it to run on this side. On this side, it makes it run on this side. So, states are self-changing in an opposite manner. This is called as oscillation. So, resonant frequency means LC circuit behaves in a very peculiar and special situation in case of when operated at resonance frequency. I hope that I tried my level best. In the next session, we'll go for energy, power and all these things. And I think module 3 and 4 we will complete, except one small bit which we will keep it, that is mutual inductance. In the first module, we have kept current source not dealt with. In the second module, transient we have not gone into the details. In the third module, mutual inductance we will keep it separately. So in next 2-3 lectures, we will complete module 3 and 4 together. Then module 6 and in few sessions, remaining part of entire syllabus. I think today we can end.